afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon.
Please sit down. I would like to take this opportunity to introduce Mr. Sandeep Johri, General Manager of Novotel Hotel and Residences, Kolkata. Okay, he comes here with a vast experience of 25 years in the hotel industry, and he's here to share his journey and insights on this industry and discuss any doubts or any, you know, apprehensions you have about this industry. I must also tell you, I've known him for a year now, and he has a great sense of humor. You'll all enjoy this session. Okay? Please put your hands together to welcome him.
Well, thank you. Thank you for the nice introduction. audible? Visible?
Yes.
You want me to get on the stage? Is it okay?
Last.
All right. Better viewing. This works?
Yes.
Telling my experience was not a part of the drill. She just wanted you all to know how old I am. So you can ignore that part. So when every year when I come here and I get this opportunity of talking to you all, I always wonder what should I be talking, because there's lots that we can talk about, I can tell you. But then, I'm mostly at loss of words with what is that you guys want to listen to me and want to know from me. Because as she said, 25 years back, I was sitting in the similar situation as you are today. And I know what you guys go through today. You do not want to listen to any gyan. You are apprehensive. Half of you would be still in doubt whether you have chosen the right career or no. Would you like the college that you are in? Are the hostel facilities good enough? Will I make good friends? And stuff like those. Am I right?
Yes.
Great. So we are on the same page. And what can I do to help you? So there's nothing. Nothing to add to the whole gamut of things that you are in. I started my career 25 years back, which means I joined hotel management 3 years before that. So I mean, I was in this position 25 plus 3, 28 years back, and a lot has changed, and a lot has changed to the betterment. But what I'm not too sure whether it has changed or no. I mean, during our days, people would get into hotel management for mostly no choice. Let's be honest. People who would not make to the engineering colleges or the medical colleges were not left with too much of options. And then hotel management was one easier one, which we all took, not knowing what the industry is all about. I don't think that is the same for you guys. You guys know what you want. You guys know why you are here. And it is such a delight to see so many people choosing hotel management as a career. I also come here every year to recruit people. So we also, I mean, I, as you would know, I am the general manager for Novotel in Kolkata. We are a part of a company called Accor Hotels, which is a huge hotel management and ownership company. So when I come here for campus interviews, and when I interview guys who have done 3-4 years of course, I mean, there's a sea change in terms of knowledge, yes, but greatly in terms of personality. So what is that you should look forward to? And academics all of course is an integral part of any education system. But what hotel management does, what this college will do to you all, is it will shape your personality. And that is what is needed. You might decide to join a hotel after you pass out, you might not join a hotel after you pass out. The option of careers are aplenty. It's not only hotels, hospitals, entertainment, retail, aviation, it's endless. I mean, you see the top facility management companies hire hoteliers to manage facilities all around the world. It is because of our ability to connect with people, our ability to organize things, to plan things, because in the due course, what all of you will become event managers, all of you will become planners, all of you will become, I mean, be it a chef or a front office, whatever that career that you will choose, you will need to plan, you will need to have focus. So this is the college, this is the profession wherein your personalities will be shaped. And no college can do that the way that hotel management does. The course is designed in a manner that you get an all-round varied experience in everything that you guys do. All right, so congratulations once again for choosing one of the best professional career streams that times can offer today. And a big round to yourself for sitting here in a college, which I believe is one of the best. All of you would have known Dr. Bose or heard of Dr. Bose. I have known him up close and very well. And I admire his personality, his passion for hospitality that he displays. So you are in excellent hands, safe hands. And all of you today should be very, very confident of the place that you're sitting in, the career that you've chosen, the college that you've chosen. A huge congratulations to all of you for what you have achieved so far. All right, so you can clap for yourself. As I said, no gyan. If it is any solace, if it is any inspiration for any of you, I can share with you my career journey, which might be of some interest to all of you. So as I said, I passed out in 1993 from Institute of Hotel Management, Kolkata, which is in Taratala. We did not have too many colleges then, and nor did we have too many hotels. Nor did we have so much of campus interview opportunities that we have these days. So as you would have guessed, I was not amongst the people who were selected into the industry through campus interviews. So I was not. And then we started our careers, and I started as an F&B supervisor and grew up the ranks. There's not a single designation that I have not worked in. From an F&B supervisor to a senior supervisor to a junior executive to assistant manager to assistant F&B manager to F&B manager to director F&B to resident manager to general manager. And this is how the career grows. And this is how most of us have grown. I mean, all the colleagues that I know, this is how we grow. So, I mean, there would be also a lot of apprehension in your mind that what, after I pass out, what happens to me? What position do I get? And what is the salary that we get to? So, these should not be a part of your worry plethora at all. What you should be worried about is how well am I doing today? Am I shaping my personality in the right way? Am I investing enough in my knowledge? Am I doing academically all right? Am I taking part in all the activities that the college give opportunity to all of you? And that should be your worry. Rest, you don't have to worry. Once you pass out, you will see that that people want you more than you want them. So that's how things have changed, and that's how it is. That is it. Can talk to you about a lot of things, but I don't think it's an opportune time. So enjoy yourself. I mean, this is something that I tell everybody every year. Have a lot of fun. You're very, very fortunate, and you do not know what you've gotten into. It is so much fun. Hotel management is so much fun. And fun, learning when you do not realize that you're learning. Every moment of your existence in the next 3 years is a learning. Learning of dealing with people, colleagues, friends, teachers, faculty. You will go for industrial exposures. There will be a lot of times that you will trainings in various hotels, you will have one-time visits to hotels. A lot of you would have visited hotels frequently. A lot of you would be there who have not visited hotels frequently. For you, it would be the first or the second time that you will see the so-called glamour world, which has so many hard-working professionals behind them. So it's going to be a lot of fun. So enjoy yourself, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. Have a lot of fun. And never, never let that take back seat. Exams will come and go, I'm sorry, but have fun. Don't be indisciplined. I mean, hello, Smita.
Hello, Mr. Johri.
And so that is it. So feel free to ask me questions, whatever that you want to, and I'll try to evade as much as I can.
I told you he has a great sense of humor.
Yeah, so ask me if in this there anything that you still have doubts about, anything that you want to know about me or the industry or things that can help you, inspire you. These chairs are too comfortable. If I was sitting there, I would have gone to sleep. This will be the first batch having induction here, no? In this hall?
Yes. With the gentleman.
Mm. Any questions?
Yes, there is one. Stand up, introduce yourself.
Get a mic asked so that everybody can hear what you want.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Kirti Gupta. Sir, Kirti, just hold on. Good morning, everyone. I'm Kirti Gupta. Sir, as you mentioned, that we should increase our knowledge. So except this college, how could we increase our knowledge? Like, how can we work on that?
Spending less time on your phones and more by reading. Keeping yourself updated with the current affairs is extremely important. This is one thing that I see lacking in the current generation. As I told you, we are people. It's a people and service-oriented industry. Current affairs, what's happening around the world is important for us to know. Reading and being aware of your surrounding is very, very important. So academics is, yes, one thing. But overall personality development happens when you have an overall, all-around knowledge which gives you the confidence of communicating. So read as much as you can. Newspapers is something that you all should make a part of your daily routine. Don't tell me that I have got 10 Times of India and ETV app. I will go through it. Reading, there's no substitute to reading. There's no substitute to reading. Appraise yourself with current events as much as you can. It will shape your personality. It will give you the confidence of talking to varied set of people that you will come across in your life ahead.
All right. Anybody else? Please ask questions. Ladies first, so you go.
Good afternoon, sir.
It's okay, speak.
Good afternoon, sir.
It's okay. You speak on the mic. It's audible.
I wanted to ask that how does hotel management shape our personality?
How it does. So, very simple, if I have to reply to this in a very simplistic manner, what constitutes a personality? When you meet somebody and how you form an opinion about somebody, saying that this guy has a good personality, this girl has a good personality, what are the factors that you see in that person? Or what constitutes a personality for you? It's not only looks, and it's least of all the looks. It is the way person carries himself, right, or herself. So what is there? As I told, I was telling that lady, one, you need to have knowledge which is needed for the confidence that you reflect. What are we? We reflect the knowledge that we have, and that gives us the confidence. Say, for example, you're getting into an exam or a viva or a group discussion or wherever, and you're not prepared. Does it show on your body? You do. I mean, your knowledge will reflect. I mean, if you know all, then your confidence, your gait is going to be much stronger. So, one, you have to, of course, have to have knowledge. What else do you need for a personality? You need to have communication skills. You need to have the ability to be able to gel in varied environment, be it a heterogeneous or homogeneous. How will you do that? There's no special class, but what happens when you do hotel management? There's a lot of activities that happen in this while you are studying. So one, initial year, you will not be able to know that what is your specialization. Then second, third year onward, you will know that I want to take housekeeping as a stream, or I want to take food production as a stream. And then you have a group formed, and then there are group activities. In group activities, what happens? You learn to work as a part of the team. You also get to learn to lead, because you will be given opportunities. So when you have those opportunities of leadership, then your personality develops, right? So you will not realize that you have practiced this so many times in the next 3 years that you will be a completely different person when you come out. But of course, you will have to be participative. You cannot be one who sits back to the last row and say, let everybody else do it and I'm chilling. So if you chill, then life's going to chill on you. Yeah? Be participative. Take part in all activities. Not necessarily that you have to be good in that, but take part. That's extremely important. Yeah?
Good afternoon, sir.
Good
afternoon. So I wanted to know, how did you face difficult times in your career?
How did I face? How did you get inspired in different times? A lot of times. It's not easy. But it's easier these days. It wasn't very easy those days. Sit. So a lot of times we have had challenging period, but if I have to reflect on one important thing that helped me tide over that was a support system. And in my case, the support system was my friends, my seniors, my colleagues, who I could fall back upon, who could advise me on the right and the wrong things to do. So it's important to have a support system. It's important. And again, you will hear me saying the same thing, that our connect with people, how we deal with people is extremely important, because that's where you make your friends, your support system, your mentors will come out of these. You will develop people that you will look up to, and you will go up to them for advice at the time of need. So you need to have that support system in the industry, which will help you tide over the tough times. And I'm not saying tough times will not come. Sometimes it is out of your control, but it is the self-belief that you should never doubt yourself. That is extremely important. And then you will. Also, remember, all of you, there's no substitute to hard work. There's no shortcut to success. This is a cliche line everybody will tell you, but this is so, so true. There is no shortcut to success. You have to work hard. And if you have examples who you think have succeeded without working hard, there could be exceptions. You cannot be lucky all the time. But hard work always pays. So never run away from working hard. All right?
Any more questions?
Good afternoon, sir. Myself, Ashman Rai. I wanted to ask that we all know that this industry is so glamorous, it's so amazing, but why opting this for as a profession, we get so much criticism?
Who said? Who criticized you?
Like you said that people consider this profession as a third hand. Like engineering first, doctor second, then this. Why?
It is not the same today. And sit down. Data suggests otherwise. And if anybody is talking like that, I mean, forgive them, because they know not what they see. And what they say is ignorance is bliss, you know, because data says that after you pass out hotel management, the highest amongst the profession that you mentioned, one of the highest rates of employment is in this industry. So data doesn't support that. I have faced it more than you would have, and I today stand here as a symbol of what they thought was wrong, right? And so will you one day. So it is, I think, ignorance or conventional belief of that generation which guides them to think that academics is not the be all and end all of learning. So people who criticize you are wrong. All the right thinking people, not right thinking, not the right people are sitting here. Right thinking is a wrong word. Yep.
Any
ladies,
more questions?
Ladies,
no? In the first row, very quiet.
I thought you handpicked them to sit there in the front row, you know.
Good afternoon, sir. Actually, I wanted to ask about
I'm here, not there. That's my photo.
Yes, I was looking at that Facebook Live and my question is about that.
All right.
So, what is the role of social media in this industry? As one teacher said, that it plays a very huge role in today's generation and in today's industrial profession and all. So what is the role? I need to hear it from you because you're a symbol here. So can you tell me about it?
The role of social media is as relevant in this industry as it is in any other industry or as it is in today's life. I mean, you can debate the amount of engagement that we have on the social media. You can debate whether how much should we be focused there, but there is no way that we can ignore that, because it is the way of working of in today's time. I mean, as hotel industry professional, social media is a quickest way of connecting with the end user. So from our point of view, while we say, for example, when we recruit people or we have to communicate with the city or the world or the country, these platforms are the quickest and the direct. This has reduced your intermediaries. So it is, earlier we used to use one channel to reach to the other. Now we can connect with the people directly. I mean, college connects with you directly, and it's so easy two-way communication on the platforms of social media that those are available today. And communication is the key. I mean, in our times, the quicker the response rate, the better it is. You know, I mean, it is like that. So time is money, and social media provides an excellent platform to do business today. So it's a welcome change as far as our industry goes, and it is unavoidable. So it has to be embraced with open arms. So one last one, if you all have any. All right.
Good afternoon, sir. I'm Sora Valentine Gomes. When you come for campus interview, what is the most important thing that you seek in the students?
There's not one. There are many. Too early for you to worry about it. Don't bother. The college is going to shape you and your personality. You will have to put in a lot of hard work that is needed at your end. And I can't really answer that question in a short sentence, because there are a lot of things that we look at, and there are multiple rounds of screening that we do when we finally take somebody on board. All right, so don't worry about it. Do everything right while you are here in this institute, and you will succeed. All of you will succeed. There's no doubt about it. All right.
Any other questions before he wraps up the session?
That is it. So boys and girls, congratulations once again for choosing hotel management as your career stream, choosing one of the best college available on the surface of earth today. And have a lot of fun while you're studying here. All right. Good luck and best wishes. See you soon. Thank you.